experiment about the Sager's figures. So what do you mean by the Sager's figures? So when a particle is acted upon by two simple harmonic motions simultaneously at right angles, means one harmonic motion is at x-axis and the other harmonic motion is acting at y-axis. So when both the harmonic motions are acting at perpendicular to each other on one particular particle, then the path is traced by a particle which gives certain pattern. This pattern is called as the Lissajous figure. So for this carry out this experiment, we have the circuit diagram. In the CRO, we have to connect the X terminal and the Y terminal to two function generators. So for one function generator, we have connected the Y component to the vertical V part of the CRO and the X component of the function generator to the horizontal plates of the CRO. So when both the X frequency and the Y frequency are acting simultaneously on the particle of the CRO, it gives a pattern which is called as Lissajous figures. So in the observation table, what we have to see? We will see the Lissajous figures like this, elliptical shape, A-type figure. Either the A-type figure is in the horizontal direction or the A-type figure would be in the vertical direction. This depends upon the frequency. What happens if the frequency of the x-axis of the x component or the frequency of the y component both are equal? Suppose this is 160 Hz and this is also 160 Hz. Then we get a spherical or elliptical Lissajous figure. But if the ratio of the x component and the y component of the frequencies are in the ratio of 1:2 or in the ratio of 2:1, like this, if it, for x axis it is 80 Hz and for y axis it is 160 Hz, so we get a horizontal A type figure. But if we have a ratio of 2:1, supposing the fx is 330 and fy is 165 Hz, so we get a vertical A type figure. Similarly, as you go on increasing or decreasing the ratios, 1:4, 2:4 or 1:8, the number of loops goes on increasing. So we can get the horizontal and vertically depending upon the ratio, whether the ratio is 2:1, 1:2, 3:1, 1:3 and so on. So this is all we have to observe in the CRO, the Lissajous patterns. So next, let's switch to the experimental apparatus. So this is our experimental apparatus. Here we have used two function generators. One function generator is for the x component of the frequency, another is for the y component of the frequency. So one function generator is connected to the x channel of the CRO and the other frequency generator is connected to the y channel of the CRO. Here we have set the frequency to be equal to 470 Hz and another we have set up to 950 Hz. So both are in the ratio of double frequency. If this is 470, this is 950 approximately, they are in the ratio of 1:2. So here when the two frequencies are coming in the function generator, so now the fx and the fy component both are acting simultaneously in the CRO. So what we observe? We observe a 8-type Lissajous figure. So this 8-type figure is corresponding to the, why it is corresponding 8-type figure? Because the frequencies are in the ratio of 1:2. Here it is 470 and here it is 950. So the fy component is double the component of fx. That is why it is coming 8-type figure. If we reverse, if we do here 900 or 1 kilohertz and here we set to be 500 Hz, then the Lissajous figure will be in the vertical direction. The A-type figure will be in the vertical direction.